What have we learned from the Schrems judgment? Given that the Commission is ready to hand the United Kingdom an adequacy decision in a too hasty way, we could think the European Union has learned nothing. But we should know better. The Privacy Shield was invalidated at European Court of Justice because of the mass surveillance practices used by the US government. And thanks to 2013 revelations of Edward Snowden, we are well aware now that the UK government uses similar mass surveillance devices. And it should be obvious to everyone that mass surveillance, indiscriminate mass surveillance, is a huge threat to our fundamental rights. European citizens have the right to not be considered first as criminals by their governments. European citizens have the right to protect their very personal and sensitive information. In concrete life, would it be possible to have someone knocking at your door every 5 minutes, trying to sell you something or make you do something, complete strangers that know everything about you, not only where you went, what you did, who you met, who are your relatives, but very intimate things, your tastes, your habits, your wishes, your frustrations, your dreams, your angers, your joys. It seems that some lobbies and maybe some people in the Commission want to bargain these fundamental rights. And this is not in the interest of citizens, but neither of business, because good business is done with good democratic rules and stability and good faith. There has been legal uncertainty for too long. There has been various attempts of prioritizing hazardous data flows for too long. First, with the US, now with the UK, but soon with third countries, which the UK government will go into trade with, not respecting any of our rules and accepting to share data with no rules. We are at serious risk of sharing personal European citizen data everywhere in the world, even with authoritarian countries.